Okay, so the first third round, why does it say round four? I don't know. Oh, I guess it is. Anyway, Tommy vs. Gizmo, the final four in the winner's bracket, is about to start. So neither of these players have yet lost the game. So to clarify how a winner's bracket and loser's bracket works, basically one player from the winner's bracket will meet one player from the loser's bracket in the grand final, and the person from the winner's bracket will only have to win the final once, but the one in the loser's bracket from the loser's bracket will have to win it twice, essentially. So the person that's never lost has an advantage. Tommy just tried to hit more buttons than he needed to then. I don't think he knows that they're shared across the two sides. Anyway, Gizmo already with the lead because he didn't mess around at the start. But he's fallen down. So Tommy with a slight lead now. So Tommy has been complaining about this map. He says that he really, really hates it, it doesn't get on with it, and this is his most hated part of the map. He'll try and do the dodge from the top of the slope, he really hates it, and he's failed it. Gizmo has made it. So Gizmo is much further ahead now. Oh, nice technique there from Gizmo. Yeah, this is looking very good for him so far. Ooh, he almost missed that, I thought. Oh wow, I had no idea you could do that. Okay, Gizmo teaching me new tricks on this map. Tommy's had another death now, not sure where that was. But it's 1-0. Gizmo, 2 minutes. Tommy's been crushed at the beginning. It's really a strong play from Gizmo at the moment. I think Gizmo's died yet. He fell here once on his first run, but he didn't die, so this is looking very, very good from him. On to the tough dodge. He misses it that time. I think Tommy will be very upset if he misses this one. Come on, Tommy. Nope. He's right off the edge. That's unfortunate. After conversations with a few different people in the division, apparently this was a mistake to be put into the list. So I suspect this map might be removed after this cup. We'll see, I guess. It doesn't seem to be very popular, at least. So Gizmo will attempt the hard dodge. Makes it. So 2 out of 3, that's really good practice and preparation from Gizmo there. So I think he does a side dodge and a jump there. That's nice technique. And I think Tommy's pretty much done for on this map. That's actually quite risky from Gizmo, I mean, I don't know how difficult that jump is, but if he misses it, he'll be right in that lava. So, yeah. And it's looking like it's going to be 2-0 on the first map. 150. Very nice. Shout out to Corny for New York City Cops. Fucking strange. Tommy choosing to take the damage there, and he's not really, well, he's not ahead and he's lost health, so this I know this map is a big favorite amongst Division 3 players. Everyone just seems to love this map. It is really well made, it looks really nice, and the obstacles are, they are unique, so, yeah. Oh! Whoa! What happened to Tommy there? I have no idea what happened to him then. It's like he hit like a corner when he dodged or something. I was not expecting that at all. See how Tommy's doing. Yeah, he's really far behind now. And Gizmo already kind of getting to the last third of the map now. Yeah, takes his time there, which is a good decision considering how far ahead that he is. So he's only got 58 health. So missing the lift jump in this room would kill him, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it would definitely kill him. So he needs to make sure he makes his lift jump. It's not a really difficult one, but... good. Ooh, really, really close. He just made it. So Gizmo's now in the safe zone of the map, really. He can't really die from that point onward. Tommy really rushed it there, but he just about made it. Gizmo setting up the flag room. You've only got to do this once. After you've done it once, you don't have to do it again for the rest of the map. So Gizmo will cap that, and Tommy's now at the lift jump. This is where Gizmo really almost died. That's a much better lift jump from Tommy there. That was a lot more comfortable. So Gizmo with about almost 30 seconds lead or something, maybe 25, I'm not really sure. I mean, all he has to do is not die pretty much, and he's won this. It doesn't matter how slow he is or how fast Tommy is now, it's... ooh! That could be enough. Tommy. So now, let's see. That's about... nice one, Tommy. Wrong direction, but you got it. Okay, that's about just less than 20 seconds difference in them now. Gizmo's still in the lead by a strong amount. So really, any mistake from either of these players, which leads to a death, will be the decider, I think. Whoa, my PC is dying. Holy shit. This is probably lagging for everyone right now, I'm not sure. I'll have to restart the stream soon. Oh my god. That's a bit better. Tommy is... yeah, he's really not that far behind. It's just, it's a shame really, both players have... oh, Gizmo! I have no idea why he missed that, that was unbelievably close. Maybe he thinks Tommy is like really close to him and he's decided to really rush, I don't know. Tommy does that fast again. So if Gizmo makes this lift jump, I think he's won this. Yeah, it doesn't fail there. I think it's a Gizmo victory. 2-0. Although if you mess up in this room, it can cost you a lot of time because you've got to wait for everything to reset. This lift is really slow if you miss it. Nah, he's done it. That's 2-0 to Gizmo. So unlucky there, Tommy. You both... ah, shit. Yeah, you both had one death each, but Tommy's death was just a lot further in the map than Gizmo's one was, so... and that was literally the only difference between you two. So, well played. So, that means... down here... Gizmo is through to the semi-final of the winner's bracket, and Tommy has been placed into the loser's bracket now, so Tommy can still effectively win the tournament. I mean, anyone in the loser's bracket can. So, Tommy will be playing whoever won that game, which Asterix is now streaming. So, we'll soon know, I guess.